Hi students, today we discuss about the analysis of variance ANOVA. This concept is very important in our statistics paper 7. So this ANOVA concepts are nearly 50% of your total syllabus. So better more concentrate on analysis of variance concept. So basically in the introduction there consider definition, assumptions and uses of analysis of variance, then causes of variations also important here. Then after that some few statements there we consider for one way and two way classifications. First, so actually this what is the use of this analysis of variance? So first check here, in our last sems there we consider small and large sample tests. In small sample tests the size is less than 30. So above 30 in the sense they use large sample test. But what's the sample? How many samples involve in small and large samples? In the sense maximum 2 samples only consider in the large and small sample test. So one sample in the sense like a single mean test is one sample. Difference of sample means in the sense it's 2 samples. Proportion, single proportion in the sense one sample, difference of proportions in the sense two samples. Suppose if any test involve more than 2 samples, how to apply the statistical analysis is the main problem. That's why more than 2 samples involve in any test, that type of situations we can use the analysis of variance concept. Is the main use of this analysis of variance. What test we apply in ANOVA? In the sense, based on the total samples, there you should divide it into different categories. Once different, suppose there is differentiate 2 categories, what's the relation between the 2 categories? Here we observe, that's why again here use the F test, but not direct F test like our last sems, but here once we consider the difference between the samples, mean difference between the samples, like the type of situations only we can use the F test. That's why in analysis of variance also we can use the F test. How to apply the F test, all that later on we'll discuss clearly. So this analysis of variance concept was introduced by our professor R.A. Fisher. So analysis of variance is a powerful statistical tool which separate the controlled and uncontrolled variations in the data, assignable and chance variations in the data. So that's why, what's the definition of ANOVA? Check it here. So analysis of variance definition is like, according to Professor R.A. Fisher, so ANOVA is the separation of variation applicable to one group of causes from variation applicable to another group of variations. Means here you should establish the various separation of the variances from different groups consider. So it is only the unknown. By using analysis of variance technique, the total variation in the sample data can be expressed as sum of variations due to some specific independent factors. So the technique ANOVA is most powerful in estimating the amount of variation due to each independent factor separately. This technique is also helpful in comparing the estimates due to various factors. Then causes of variations, already there you consider assignable cause and chance cause. So assignable cause in the sense this detected and measured. So but chance cause in the sense it's not detected, it's not in our control also. That's why there's chance causes are considered as uncontrolled variations. Like suppose one prediction is going on, that's why in that time that meanwhile there one power cut involved there, in the sense the production will stop, again the production will start, in the sense meanwhile if any error involved there, it's not in our human hand. So natural cause only, it's, that's why it's uncontrolled cause. Uncontrolled causes considered as the chance causes. Assumptions of analysis of variance. So before going to the classification, here you consider some assumptions. What are the assumptions involved here is, observations are independent, each and every observation is independent to each other. So the parent population from which the sample observations are taken is normal. From the normal distribution only you consider the different observations. Various treatments and environment factors are additive in nature. So it is also one of the very important. Suppose there you consider one-way classification, two-way classification. There the model is like yij equal to mu plus alpha I plus beta j plus epsilon ij like that. So all are involved there, additive manner, additive in nature. Once you can consider the classification, there some few statements involve like Cochrane's theorem and Gauss Markov linear model. In Cochrane's theorem, mainly they use the sum of situations, sum of squares of situations we can use. So the total sum of squares is equal to the individual sum of squares. It is only the Cochrane's theorem. Summation xi square is q1 plus q2 plus and so on plus qk. Like suppose, so there are 5 treatments, each treatment consists of the 5 observations. Suppose, so 4 treatments and 5 observations are there, in the sense, so total 20 observations are there. The sum of the total 20 squares of the observations is equivalent to first treatment, all the observations squares and addition. Second treatment, all the observation squares and sums. Third treatment, all the squares and sums. Fourth treatment, all the squares and sums individually find, then add. So it is also gives the total sum of squares. That's why summation yi square xi square is equal to q1 plus q2 plus and so on plus qk. All that elaborately there you define. So qj by epsilon, qj by sigma square is the chi square variate with rj degrees of freedom. That's why summation rj is capital N. Rj indicates here size of the each row, total sizes, all the treatments totals add, in the sense it gives the size of the sample. Then Gauss Markov linear model. So this is very important in our classification. So based on this only they will consider the mathematical model. Or so Gauss Markov linear defined like straight line format only, but each letter indicates here different sizes of matrices. So once we multiply that matrices, it gives our like equation format is like a linear equation. So y equal to a beta plus epsilon. Y indicates all the given observations like y1, y2 and so on, yn. So like a is n by m coefficient matrix, like a11, a12 and so on, a1 m. So a21, a22 and so on, a2m, like that an1, an2 and so on, anm. Like beta 1 is another unknown parametric vector, so it's like beta 1, beta 2 and so on, beta m. Epsilon is also another vector of error here, epsilon 1, epsilon 2 and so on, epsilon n. Then assumptions of the model consider. So epsilon follows here n of 0 comma sigma square I. So all that I is an identical matrix of order n. Expectation of epsilon is 0. Expectation of epsilon epsilon dash is sigma square I, like this product covariance is here 0. So that's why, because of the variables are independent here, that's why that both are same. I equal to j, in the sense it gives expectation of x square. So expectation of x square, in the sense it is variance sigma square. That you should remember all these assumptions here. So this is about the introduction of analysis of variance, define analysis of variance, causes of variations and assumptions of analysis of variance. These are the ANOVA related concepts. Then short answer here, Gauss Markov linear model is one of the important one, like another Cochrane's theorem is also another important short answer here. You should prepare all this clearly, so easily can score 2 short answers out of all these. Like now enter into the essay type here. The essay type very important concepts are here, one-way classification and two-way classification. It's somewhat lengthy but easy only, then you can follow that step by step. manner. First consider the data, then linear mathematical model, then apply the least squares method. After applying the least squares method, then go through the degrees of freedom. After that, sum of squares, mean sum of squares, F calculated value, F critical value. All this total information you should write in the form of one table. That table is called the ANOVA table. After that, conclusion. These are the different steps in the classification. First, you consider the ANOVA for one-way classification. There, you consider the observations YIJ is I equal to 1 to J, K, sorry, I equal to 1 to K, J equal to 1 to N. Like that, if same size in the sense N1 equal to N2 equal to N1, NK equal to N, whatever it is, no issue here. So either unequal size or equal size is also no issue. Effect of the treatments, error due to chance, all that here we consider. So this is the given data format. So values of variables consider Y11, Y12, and so on, YN. Y1, N1, so means size is different here, Y21, Y22, and so on, Y2, N2, this is another different size, like Y1, Y2, and so on, YINI is the another different size here, so YK1, YK2, and so on, YKNK is the kth treatment, different observations, total of each treatment consider here, then means also find here, so mean of the mean we consider y bar dot dot, actually it is not y bar dot dot is defined as 1 by k summation y bar I dot, like that consider, so g is the grand total, y bar dot dot is the overall mean, then mathematical model consider for this analysis of variance in the sense. So observe here, only one way is there, only classes or treatments are only the given here, so no two way here, so that's why only row wise data is there, that's why one way classification is fit for this our given data. So what's the mathematical model involved here is overall mean is one thing here, the another thing is, so there is a difference between the treatments like that consider, that's why. So YIJ is considered as mu plus alpha I plus epsilon IJ. Mu indicates overall mean, alpha I indicates treatment wise effects, epsilon IJ indicates error treatments. YIJ is the yield from jth unit by receiving or applying ith treatment like that. All that expand here. So like assumptions of the model consider, all the observations are independent, it's very familiar assumption only. So various effects are additive in nature, already I told clearly, linear mathematical model in the sense, it is in the form of additive only, then epsilon ij follows identically independently distributed normal distribution with mean 0 and variance sigma square e. So symbolically epsilon ij follows n of 0 comma sigma square e, consider variance is sigma square e, means are 0 e, so then only it's identically independently distributed. Like null hypothesis consider, so null hypothesis h naught is here, mu 1, mu 2 and so on, mu k is equal to mu say, so otherwise, so like treatment effect wise consider in the sense, alpha 1 equal to alpha 2 equal to and so on, alpha k equal to 0, all the treatment effects do not differ significantly, means all the treatment effects are same here. So statistical analysis consider, y bar I dot is the mean of the ith class, y bar dot dot is the overall mean. So mathematical model consider here, yij is mu plus alpha I plus epsilon ij. So from that, so here we consider error sum of square. So how to consider error sum of square here is, so yij is the given value, mu plus epsilon I, mu plus alpha I is the estimated value, here error is epsilon ij, that's why epsilon ij consider yij minus mu minus alpha I. So error sum of square in the sense, sum of square of that error consider here. So E is double summation yij minus mu minus alpha I whole square. Then the normal equations for estimating mu and alpha I are dou E by dou mu equal to 0 consider, dou E by dou alpha I equal to 0 consider. These are well known only. Why? Because of, I think so this is the third time. So we discussed in the third sem as well as in fifth sem also, that's why these are familiar for you. So partial differentiation apply, so 2 into double summation of this, so then double summation apply here, so finally it gives mu is 1 by capital N double summation y is a, it is y bar dot dot. So summation ni alpha is 0, how in the sense like this. Then dou e by dou alpha is equal to 0, so with respect to alpha I only, dou by dou alpha I of this. So here summation is particularly considered here with respect to alpha I, that's why no summation alpha I involve here. So summation j of this one also, okay? So once you apply like this, so then alpha epsilon I j is like this, will get before that alpha I is y bar I dot minus y bar dot dot, epsilon ij is yij minus y bar I dot. So from that you should substitute in mathematical model, the mathematical model becomes like this. So substitute that mu and alpha I here and take the deviation formula. Suppose we simplify this, in the sense there is no use, yij equal to yij only. Our purpose of taking all these sum of squares here, in the sense, it's deviation format conversion only. So from the deviations, there is to take the summing and squaring for the deviations. After that, then go through the sum of squares, then degrees of freedom, then mean sum of squares. So for all these purpose sake only, there you consider the deviation format. The deviation is from the respective means only consider here. Yij minus y bar dot dot, y bar I dot minus y bar dot dot, yij minus y bar I dot. All are deviate from the mean only. That's why they squaring and summing over I and j on both sides. So like square and double summation here. So like this consider. Then a sum double summation a square plus double summation b square plus 2 of like that consider. So then this product is 0. Then squaring, this is related to treatment, this is related to error, like this is related to total. That's why since the product is here vanished, how to vanish in the sense like this. So in our one way classification, if any product sum of squares is, sum of products are there in the sense, it should be vanished like 0 only, like this. So that's why first one is related to total sum of square, then treatment sum of square, error sum of square. TSS is SST plus SSE. What is TSS? A total sum of square, we should write. Treatment also should write like this. Then error is also like this. Then degrees of freedom consider. Capital N is the total size. That's why for total sum of squares, capital N minus 1 is the degrees of freedom. Then K treatments are there. That's why sum of squares due to treatment, degrees of freedom is K minus 1. So how to get error in the sense? Total minus treatment, it gives the error. Like mean sum of square MSS, so S square T, so mean sum of square in the sense, so ratio between sum of squares and its respective degrees of freedom, S square T is SST by K minus 1, so MSS for error is S square E is SSE by N minus K. Like that F statistics here is ratio between two mean sum of squares or ratio between two variances. Here instead of the variances, there you consider mean sum of squares. That's why F is S square T by S square E follows F of K minus 1 comma N minus K degrees of freedom. So all this information you should write in the form of table. This is very important ANOVA table for every classification. You should remember this table clearly. So first consider the variations, then sum of squares, degrees of freedom, mean sum of squares, F cal, F critical. So variations consider like this, sum of squares like this, degrees of freedom already everything we discussed before only, but all that total 3 to 4 pages information you should write in the form of table. Easily it gives our result. So based on this table, you should conclude the problem here. So based on F cal and F critical, you should have less than F cal less than F table in the sense it gives acceptance, is greater than in the sense rejection. If accept in the sense all the treatments are same, if reject in the sense the treatments are not clear here, then by using this ANOVA for one-way classification, so you should solve some problems. For that sake, this total sum of squares, mean sum of squares, all that expand clearly. That's why specific formulas for calculation say consider capital G is grand total double summation yij, RSS is raw sum of squares, means individual squares and sums. then total sum of square find here like this. After simplification easily can remember. So TSS is a double summation yij square minus capital N into g square. So this capital N by capital N square g square like this consider, in the sense it is a CF correction factor. Later on consider all individual squares and sums are there, that's why RSS minus g square by N. So g square by N considered as a correction factor. So CF like SST consider like this. So then SSE in the sense total minus treatment only. So by seeing this problem easily can identify this is only treatment data, that's why one way classification can apply. First to find the grand total RSS, all these are the different formulas involved here. Then ANOVA table consider, then enter into the calculations here. TI dot find, TI dot square by NI find, summation YJ square find. This total is called double summation YJ square. This is summation TI dot square by NI. This is grand total G. So like size N1, N2, all this we consider. So then easily can find TSS, SST, then SSE. After that ANOVA table, this F critical value given in the problem only, don't bother about this F critical. So here F critical value is 3.63, F calculated is 1.098, that's why F cal less than F critical. So we accept the null hypothesis H0, that's why there is no difference between any treatment. So all the treatments are same only here, that's why any treatment considered for our statistical investigation is also no issue. So the given data is perfect like this. So if greater than in the sense, it's not like that. So greater than in the sense, it's rejected. There is a difference between treatments, but here not like that, less than only they will get, that's why we accept H0, all the treatment effects are same only here. So better more concentrate on one way classification, means the remaining total 1.5 units is very simple, that's why you should more focus on this one way classification first. In the next session we'll discuss the two way classification after that. So design of experiments all should more focus on studies, please be serious and prepared. Thank you.